Hello, BookTube. Welcome to Lizzie Faye Loves Books. I'm Elizabeth, and it's Thanksgiving, and I am at my brother's house, so thought it would be fun to introduce you to my brother, Clay. And you've already met my sister, Sharla, if you saw our video that we did this summer. And I thought it would be fun if we did a little BookTube challenge. And I've seen the Judge a Book by Its Cover challenge done with, like, Joe from a retired book nerd did it with her daughters, and I thought, even when I saw the video a couple years ago, that it would be really fun to do this with my siblings, and they were both willing to do it. So what I've done now, both of them are readers, but I picked out some YA fantasy books that I've read that I doubt that they have read, just to see if just to make it a little more fun and see if they might want to guess what the books are about. So the way this is played, I'm going to hold up a book, I'm going to let each of them take a minute to look at it, and then they're going to take turns guessing what they think the book is about. Now, if you already know what the book's about, you could say, oh yeah, I've heard of this, but still go ahead and say what you think. So, the first one I have is going to be probably an easy one, but this is just to kind of get used to what we're doing, because this one I'm sure they've heard of because it has a movie, but the first one is Hunger Games. So I'm going to let you guys both look at it. You can look at the back, too. Oh, I don't know. Maybe you're not supposed to look at the back. No, I think that tells what it's about.
You're not.
Maybe just look at the front cover. Oh, okay. Katie says just to look at the front. Okay. Who wants to go first? What do you think this book is about?
It's about a totalitarian society where some young people rebel in their own way against it and play within the rules of the oppressive government.
All right, so good job, Clay. He knew exactly what this one was about. And I kind of figured that they might know what this one was about because this one is pretty mainstream. But no, Charlotte, that's not what this one is about. She knows. She knows what it's about. All right, so that's how the game is played. And now, next, we're going to start with one that perhaps they don't know. This one is City of Bones. So I'll let Charlotte look at it for first this time. While Clay's looking at it, Charlotte can be...
Well, this is a YA book, so it's a city that has a lot of dead people that are buried in it.
I bet that...
I think it's about building a skyscraper and they discover that there's a lost cemetery there and they can't build a skyscraper.
All right, I guess, what do you think, Charla? I think Charla got the point for that one. It's not exactly what it's about, but you came closer. So it's a fantasy book about shadow hunters y'all know what it's about. You've all heard of it.
The story was more logical, but since it's a fantasy, it's a fantasy
book. Yeah. So it's a story about shadow hunters, and they have to deal with, like, underworld characters and things like that. So I'm not the best expert on it. I've read a few of them, but you were the closest. All right, so here's the next one. This one might be obvious too. All right. It's The Selection.
I think it's about society where only the attractive people get to survive and the rest of them are eliminated.
I think it's about the dress. I think it's either prom and somebody's going to get picked prom queen, or it's about a beauty pageant. And it's about who gets selected as the winner of the beauty pageant and why, but it's all about the dress.
Okay, well, neither of you are correct. No, The Selection is about a kind of futuristic society where there is a prince who is able to, it's kind of almost like The Bachelor, but so all of these young ladies from all the different castes, it's a caste system. So they have the upper crust as well as all the way down to the poverty girls, but some from each group are eligible to come, and they dress them up pretty, and the prince gets
it's
to
like
select.
Queen Esther in the Bible.
Okay, well, but he just has to pick one. He doesn't get to have all of them. He has to pick one as he as whoever is going to be his selection. So this one girl, America singer, she is from one of the lower castes. Her name is America. Yeah, this is like futuristic. It's not America anymore, but her father named her America because it's a historic name. So, all right, this is a middle grade. Well, I shouldn't tell you that. Katie's looking at me like,
Gregor
the Overlander.
It's kind of like the postman, where this, you know, maybe it's after some war, and Gregor goes around the land doing whatever he finds out. That's about Gregor. He goes across the country. He's the Overlander.
She was a romance writer.
No, she's the author of Hunger Games.
Oh, no, that's right.
But there's a Collins that was...
Jackie Collins.
Yes.
Something about. Yeah. I think that Gregor is a messenger in a society where things have gone back to primitive roots, and he in charge of an important message that he has to deliver from one part of the country to another.
What do you think, Katie?
Oh, I didn't hear hers.
Oh, yeah, she didn't hear. What
was it? It's like that movie, The Postman, where it was after a war in America, and so it was kind of similar.
All right. So, Gregor is actually a young boy who, he basically finds himself down underground in an underland world where there's giant bats and giant cockroaches and giant rats and everything. This one you may have heard of, so this might be an easy one. This is The Giver.
I think it's closer.
Did you not see this movie?
What was the name of the movie?
The Giver.
It's like the same as The Giver. And it won a John Newbery medal. I think The Giver is about Santa Claus in disguise as a very benevolent person who gives people things when they least expect it, good things. At other times of the year.
Okay.
It's just about an elderly man whose elderly people are often judged by their looks, and people don't get past that, but they come to love this man because he is very giving and kind and does a lot of kind things for other people.
Okay. Well, neither of you are very close, but I'd say probably you are a little closer just because... Was it not right? Okay. This is also a dystopian society where you think at first everything is good, but everybody is given their jobs to do and everything, and this man has been the receiver. He's the receiver of memories, and now it's his turn to pass on the memories to everyone else because all of the people in the society are basically kept in the dark about all of history because their society now wants them all to be happy and not remember wars and things like that. So one person in the community is the only one keeping the memories of the world, all the wars, and now he's got to pass it on to a new boy that's been chosen. And so now he becomes the giver, and the young boy becomes the receiver. His name is Jonas, is that right? Yeah. So it's a very good, like you noticed, it's a Newbery winner. It's probably one of my favorite Newbery winners. It's kind of a YA middle grade level book, but they made a movie out of it that's really good. So I'll give Charlotte that point. Oh, I didn't hold it up. I should hold it up. The Maze Runner.
Yeah.
Almost done.
Well, it looks like a city of skyscrapers is a maze, and someone has to make their way around this city that looks like it's grown up with ivy. Maybe it's been after a war, and kind of like the Planet of the Apes, which probably you guys don't never have heard of, that where moss is grown over the skyscrapers, and that's like a maze, and they're finding their way through it.
Okay, I think it's about a young man who finds himself thrown up through an underground elevator into a walled, grassy area, and he has no idea where he is, and he soon discovers that there are others being thrown up that same tunnel behind him, and they discover these movable walls that create passages into a giant maze out into areas where they think they may be able to escape because they're in a walled fortress where they can't escape. They have no memory of how they got there, and eventually they find a way out of that through a lot of twists and turns and near-death experiences, and they discover they're in a lab, and they also discover that these scientists have placed them in this grand experiment to prepare them for a society that's post-war outside of this enclosed community.
I'm the only decent character dies.
Well,
the funny thing is, I thought he was making all that up. That's how crazy it was.
My 64-year-old brother knows his YA literature. That's amazing.
You must have seen the movie.
Did you see the movie? Did you like to read the book? Saw the movie. Very good. Very, very good. All right. Now, I have one more YA and then one adult book. Oh, yeah. Okay, so you go first.
You should get a Percy Jackson.
I went first last time.
No, you didn't. She went first, and you were the one that okay. went on and on about it.
Yeah. Okay. The Lunar Crime.
Yes.
Oh, Cinder. Well, this must be a play on Cinderella, so I'm guessing that this is a vampire named Cinderella that comes out at night and terrorizes the prince.
You're right. I think it's a take on Cinderella because at midnight she, you know, coach turned back into a pumpkin, and I don't know why you see her bones in here unless she's a robot. Okay, it's a robot Cinderella.
Maybe. She's actually a cyborg. You got that point. Very good. Yes, Cinder is the first in the Lunar Chronicles, and the reason it's the Lunar Chronicles is because they're about to be at war with the moon. The queen of the moon is the evil queen in this Cinderella retelling, and Cinder is a cyborg, and so that's why you see her robot parts. It's kind of like the Bionic Woman, where she was injured as a child, and so they replaced parts of her parts with robot parts. But yeah, very good.
So that was actually where the front cover did help me a little bit.
All right, now this one I just got through reading. This is the only adult book I put in here, but I just thought it'd be kind of fun to throw this one in. I just read this for book club, What Alice Forgot. So you're trying to go first.
You should get a Percy Jackson book.
Well, you can bring one in.
I think this is about someone who's going through dementia, and maybe they're in their early stages and they realize they can have that, but don't know what to do about it. Or it could be about how the family is having to deal with it.
Is this a fantasy book?
It is not.
Okay.
Is it a heart attack?
I think that Alice worked for the CIA, but she is in the early stages of Alzheimer's, and it comes in goes with her, and she ends up sharing enough about her past life that it creates a dilemma for her former employers, and they figure out a way to secretly drug her and reprogram her where she won't remember.
That sounds interesting.
That does. I'd like to read that one. But no, that's not what this one's about. I don't know. You want to vote this? This is about a woman who's about to turn 40, and she hits her head at the gym, and when she wakes up, she can't remember the last 10 years of her life at all. And all of her kids are under the age of 10, so she doesn't even remember her children. And she's also getting a divorce, and she only remembers being in love with her husband. And so the whole last 10 years are just missing out of her life. So that's what it's about. You might like to read it. So anyway, that's what else we got. All right, now Katie, and in fact, now, Tate and Tanner, you want to run in the video real quick? They wanted to say, I don't think Katie wants to get in. Just come and say hi. Okay, all right. Well, okay. I didn't bring anyone here. But anyway, Tate and Katie have both been reading all of the Percy Jackson books. So they wanted Clay and Charla to look at these books and see
so
if
they... So you already know what this is about?
No.
Pretty much, you probably
yeah.
Do
you know what it's about?
Tanner, what do you think this book's about?
So it's people trying to save other people.
Oh, yeah.
Is that right?
You're not wrong.
That's pretty
good.
Yeah. Is that right?
You're not supposed
that's
to read the
back. That's pretty good. All right, so Katie brought in, she brought in the last Olympian. She wanted them to see if they could...
Well, first of all, did I get it right?
You did get it right, yeah.
I thought that was... Well,
the same thing?
Yeah. Like the same thing?
Yeah. So you judge the white cover. That's the
all right, come in.
High five. Yeah. All right.
Okay, well, I think maybe The Last Olympian is about the Greek mythological character Perseus suddenly reappearing in modern-day New York City and competing in the modern day Olympics.
Oh, well, that would be an interesting story.
Maybe it's the story about why there was a break in the Olympics. Why did they end and then what got them started again?
No, I'm afraid not. Percy Jackson is a modern day demigod. He's named after Perseus. But he is a son of Neptune or
Poseidon.
Poseidon.
What?
Depending on which series you're in. He's the son of Poseidon. And so this is the this is the fifth book and the last book in this series. But yeah, so that was really fun, you guys. Thanks for joining me on my BookTube channel.
Thank you.
And thanks for being good sports about it. And okay. I have to say, I'm impressed.
So when you edit, you'll have to come up with a score.
Yeah. And I don't know.
We all want it.
Yeah.
It was just fun, yeah. You all get good
but that was Cowboys one.
Yeah.
I don't know yet.
So that is it for this video. Hope you're having a great day. Read a good book, and God bless you.
Peace.